I don't care what anyone says. There is no replicating the good old doctor. Only doctor I need in my life.
Threw a snowball at the dog?
Wow.
Okay.
Pretty sure a little bit more nitrogen and lime will absolutely fix this situation we got going on right here. Of the many things that I learned in my time at domyown.com was resistance to chemicals, both with pests and in the lawn. We've all heard the saying, an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure, meaning if you prevent the disease from creeping in, then it's gonna be way more effective than trying to get rid of it while it's actively in your lawn. So, and one of the things that I've learned is rotating the fungicides or fungicide rotation to tackle the disease that's in your yard. What does that mean? Why do we do it? Is it a thing? Let's dive into that right now. I say, is this a thing? Because while I was at domyown.com, one of the things that was raised by a customer was, is this actually a thing, or is this just chemical companies out there telling you that you have to do this as a marketing ploy to sell more products? So once again, I turned to the Google gods and typed in this whole idea of fungicide rotations, and here's what I came up with. When you're researching this, one of the things that you'll uncover is this thing called FRAC codes. What the FRAC is that? According to the Michigan State University's website, FRAC stands for the Fungicide Resistance Action Committee, which was developed in order to create a numerical coding system to help you identify products that attack fungi in distinctively different ways. Yeah, so a bunch of nerdy people got together, figured out, hey, let's put this numerical coding system on all these different fungicides so that you can say, hey, use a 1 for this and then rotate to using a 12 for this. I think that's how that goes. We'll get into that in a minute. FRAC codes are usually gonna appear as a text box on the bottle so you can easily identify what they are and what group they belong in. Let's cut to the chase and put this in very simple, easy terms to understand. Simply put, if fungicides are in the same group number, they're gonna act the same. If they have a different group number, they're gonna act differently. So a group 1 is gonna act differently than a group 11. According to the Michigan State University's website, rotating among fungicides with different FRAC numbers will help delay development of resistance to any one mode of action. So similar to pests, you use something over and over and over again, they can build up a resistance or a tolerance to that chemical, which is why you want to rotate between the different modes of action or different chemicals, whatever you want to call it. You want to rotate through those so that you do not build a resistance to it. Diving further into the research, going over to the University of Nebraska's website, they give you a nice step-by-step guide on how to build a fungicide program for your needs. Highlighting some of the things that they point out, the first step, surprise, surprise, gain a familiarity with a disease that affects the turf you manage. So if you know you've got a particular disease in your yard and it's coming, you'll know what to buy and how to effectively prevent it from overtaking your yard. Remember, ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. The next step that they point out on their website is decide what your application trigger will be. Will you apply when you first notice symptoms, when environmental conditions are favorable for disease development, or a combination of the two? In other words, you're going to be reactive to this. If you start to see the problem, you'll jump on it, or you're going to research out what the disease is, know if heat and humidity are going to cause it to creep in. Is it going to be after the winter months, after snow is melted, you'll have some snow mold problems? Figure that out next in your program. After you've gone through those steps, this might come as a shocker as well, but third thing you need to do is effectively choose a fungicide or fungicides. Again, you want to rotate between them to control the active diseases in a given month. You'll then need to plan and figure out how often you need to apply that fungicide. Is it going to be every 7 days, every 14 days, every 3 weeks, once a month? What is the interval going to be? Put that down on a calendar and stay on top of it. And then again, go in and look at what different groups you need to tackle that. So maybe a group 1 for the first 14 days, and then a group 11 or 12 or whatever the case may be for the next 14 days,
and bounce back and forth between those two until you've got the disease under control. Fourth thing on their list, once a reapplication interval has been determined, it's time to again select a fungicide or fungicides to apply. As part of protecting the useful life of fungicides we use, it's best not to use the same fungicide repeatedly. Instead, we should rotate chemical classes with a new application or tank mix different chemical classes and apply both simultaneously. And that's where that fungicide rotation idea comes into play, right? You want to use one chemical for a set amount of time and then rotate to a different one until you've effectively gotten the disease under control. And fifth thing that they recommend is to be proactive. You know you've got a disease problem, you know what possibly causes it. Now make a plan for the rest of the season or even make a plan for next season on what you can do to prevent it from coming back. It does work. I remember back in Georgia when I planted turf type tall fescue in my backyard, Bermuda in the front, I definitely had disease problems with the turf type tall fescue. It's really humid in Georgia. Surprise, surprise. You might not know that, but it is. And I had disease creep in on that cool season lawn. So I had to go through this fungicide rotation thing to get it under control. Was it cheap? No, it was pretty expensive to buy the different fungicides that I needed in order to tackle the problem, but it does work. I think the best thing that you can do is figure out what the disease is, what are the chemicals that are going to control it, maybe even use just the one and do a preventative application to see if that'll just, you know, prevent it from coming into your lawn. And hopefully you don't have to go through this whole fungicide rotation thing to keep the disease out of your lawn. But if you do, now you know what to do. What did I leave out? What are your thoughts? Have you had experience with this? What has that been? Let me know. Sound off in the comment section below. I hope you enjoy this format, this style of video. I certainly enjoy researching the topic, going on the different Extension Office websites, and learning all about this kind of stuff. If you liked it, hit that thumbs up. Let me know again in the comment section below. Share it out with all your friends, family, neighbors, loved ones. Send them a tweet. Maybe hit them up on MySpace. Whatever it is you cool kids do. Send them the video if you enjoyed it. Make sure you're subscribed. If you're not already, click the bell to get the notifications every time I upload a new video. Keep on keeping on, and I will catch you in the next one.